Next up, we've got a very special thing because a lot of kids don't really realise the hours involved in making a record. So we borrowed Jeff Cox, who's the third best drummer in Australia, to do a little bit of a film for us to show you a little bit of how a record is made. So let's have a look at it now, eh?
There are seven major record companies here in Australia releasing something like 15 albums and 30 singles a week. But that's only rock and disco. That doesn't include your classical, your country, your compilation albums and so on. We're at EMI's production and distribution plant here in Sydney. And this is where the Australian Crawls debut single first saw its light of day. But this little piece of black vinyl could easily be mistaken as a bad taste drink coaster unless we go from the beginning.
Dibble be ball, got a price upon me, hey yeah. Got some friends who just flew in from LA. But you, Dribble People, they haven't really much to say. Except people, they just want to take you. People, they just want to.
This is where it all begins, in the studio. The boys can spend anything up to a week recording, doing takes and retakes to get the best possible sound on our little bit of vinyl. Two of the guys that really helped the band tie the whole thing together are the producer and the engineer. Let's take a look at that.
Okay, fellas, we'll go from the top again. Can you try and remember the timing? Because you're just sort of tending to sway out of tempo a little bit and it's just not quite working.
Okay, Dave, let's do it.
The producer and the engineer pull together the band's creative activity and output out in the studio and bring it in here through a maze of panels and switches in this recording desk. Each guitar sound, drum sound, each musical sound and each vocal sound comes up on a different channel in the desk, and there's up to 40 channels in this one, which makes it a heck of a lot easier to record. The sound has come from the band through the desk onto a multi-track machine, which then in turn goes to the mixdown studio for a whole new process to begin. Piece of cake, really. Tell that to Paul McCartney. Well, here we are in the mixdown suite, and that multi-track we talked to you about before is now being fed into another fancy desk, and eventually, after it's gone through all this and been fiddled with a bit, we're going to end up with our final stereo master tape, and we're going to be able to cut our first record. But before we do, computers are into everything these days. Have a look at this, will you? I don't believe it. This is what we've finally been after, our stereo master tape. And it's now time to cut the groove in the record. So we transfer from here into this fancy panel, which in turn takes us to our cutting lathe, which actually cuts the groove in the lacquer. And then it's off to the factory. Meanwhile, elsewhere...
Your name wouldn't be Deirdre, by any chance.
Oh, sorry. Promotion and selling of the record happens right here. But it all happens well in advance of the record being available to you. I tell you what, it's bigger than Ben-Hur here, isn't it? Look at this. People everywhere, like this all the time.
Sales reps and promotions people across Australia receive advance copies to take to radio, retailers and press for reviews and things. In the case of an album, the cover art and associated packaging, posters, etc. would be developed by the art department to complement the music and the image that the band needs to project.
At the factory, the acetate disc, which is now called the lacquer, goes through a series of silver and nickel baths to produce a solid, hard-wearing base to stamp out thousands of records. The lacquer becomes a stamper once it's been formed into shape for the pressing machine. As there are A and B sides to a record, so two stampers have to be made. The stampers, along with labels and a glob of vinyl, are placed in a giant sandwich maker to form our record. With a bit of trimming and a paper sleeve, that's basically all you need to make a hit record. Well, I guess that's about it. The orders have come through. The records are now in their boxes on the way out to the shops and to you. And it seems to me like a perfect opportunity to have a look and listen to what all the fuss has been about. Here's the Australian crawl and beautiful people.
Saturday, Dibble Bebop. They've got a rubber politician in their travel bag.